Hi everyone, this is Mom Loves Dolls Too, and today I wanted to share a really cool gift that I got from my daughter. It is a special Barbie sized doll called You Dolls. And what it is, you go to a website and you get to create and pick out a doll of your liking. You get to choose the details of your doll. And in this case, we chose to make a doll that looks like my daughter. And I found out about You Dolls back in August of 2015. This is the box that the dolls come in, or should I say the outer box. And YD stands for You Dolls. And I found out about them from Kickstarter. So it was an up and coming company, and you fund them to get them started. And they created their website, and they finally went live in December, and my daughter and I were able to go ahead and get her pre-paid for gift. So now, next I'm going to show you the inside box, which my daughter obviously has already opened because she got it in early December. So this is the box that comes inside, and up here you can see where it says You Dolls. And then you get to choose a background of your choosing. My daughter chose the Eiffel Tower. And the neat thing about this box is that not only you get to choose what the box looks like, you also get to choose a name for your doll. So we chose my daughter's nickname, which is Katie, K-A-T-Y. And so that is what the doll comes in. And now, as you can see, the doll is standing behind there. So I'm going to go ahead and bring her forward so you can see exactly what she looks like. And like I said, here she is. And we did try to make her like my daughter. And she is Barbie size type of doll. And so we chose her to have the brown hair. There's only one color of brown hair. And we chose the wavy. She does have rooted hair. My daughter braided her hair, so that's why you can see some of her scalp back there. And we chose the eye color. We chose green. The face mold, I believe, is all the same, but you can choose the skin color. They have light, medium, and dark, and my daughter's light skin, so we chose light skin. And we can also choose the outfit. And because they're new and up and coming, they don't have a lot of choices, but they do have quite a few at the moment you can choose from, just not a lot. So my daughter chose this adorable top, and it's a cute little tank top with the spaghetti straps. It's got the lace right here, and it's black with white polka dots, and it has a little bit of lace right here on the bottom as well. And the back is Velcro. Really cute. And then she chose these adorable jeans, and the jeans do have the faux pockets in them, which is super cute. So she's got three pockets, and it has a removable belt, so it's got the little belt loops, and it velcros in the back so you can remove the belt and, you know, also get the pants on and off. She does not have painted underwear per se. The underwear is like a nude color, so it matches her skin. And she is articulated. She's articulated here in the wrist and the elbows, and so her hands can move in pretty much any direction. Her head does not tilt, but it does go sideways. And let's see the back. She's a little bit thicker, I would say, than a normal Barbie sized doll. So she's a little bit thicker up here at the top and thicker down here. So she's not like a skinny waif like Barbie dolls are. And then her feet are not articulated, and you do get to choose the style of shoes that you want. My daughter chose the only pair of sneakers that they have, and they come in pink, and they're a little snug to put on and off, but her feet are shaped in the heels that Barbies usually are. And she's not articulated here, as you can see, but she is articulated at the knees, so that's a good touch. And we paid for this doll as a before the website started and as a pre-order type of thing, $49.99 to pay for the doll and pay for everything that the doll is included with. So you get not only the doll and the outfit, and you get to choose her details and shoes, but you also get to choose four items. And I will go ahead and Okay, show so you. I am back. I'm going to go ahead and show you the items that you can choose for this adorable doll. And as you can see, she was standing on her own because of the flat shoes. So that's pretty cool. But I'm going to go ahead and just sit her right here on the edge of this desk and show you what was a selling point for me for this doll was that you can actually choose four items of your choosing, or at least it was in the beginning. Now you have to choose from like a four pack. But anyhow, we were still able, because we did the pre-order, we were able to get what we chose. And the main item I chose for my daughter was a trumpet. So this is absolutely adorable because my daughter is a trumpet player. So how perfect is that? And the doll can actually hold it, and I will take photos of the doll holding it at the end so we can show you that. So you can choose from a few different instruments. Another item you can choose, which was a big selling point for me as well, was you can choose a pet. Now, they only had a few pets to choose from. It was a dog and a cat, but they had the one that I wanted, which was a ferret. How cute is this? Absolutely adorable, and I have never seen a ferret for any type of dolls, especially Barbies. Now, the reason why we love ferrets is that my kids grew up with ferrets. We had ferrets for like the past 15 years, and only in the last almost 2 years have we not had ferrets because they all passed away, and we just kind of gave up on them for a little while because it's so sad to say goodbye to so many ferrets. But those are two of the items of the four that my daughter could choose from. The third item she chose was a cell phone. So here is the little cell phone. Don't know if you can see that very well. This I'm not very thrilled about. It's just very simple, but it is doll size, and so it's, you know, it's cute. But that was not a selling point. I didn't think that that was a big deal. They can do better with the cell phones, maybe give an iPhone type of one, or like a tablet. Yeah, tablet I think would be even better. And then the fourth item we chose was another accessory, and that was a television. So this I thought was adorable. So it says live from Fashion Week, and it has a doll on the front from YouDolls. And it's relaying You Do Doll news. So this is adorable because it can go obviously in the Barbie doll houses. And it's just adorable because they don't seem to sell those alone as a accessory for your dolls. And then they were very kind to us and gave us some bonus items. One of the items that we had chosen instead of the cell phone or the TV, I can't remember which one, was a little like figurine. And so we had chosen the Eiffel Tower, and as a bonus, they went ahead and gave it to us anyway when we changed our mind and decided to get the TV and the cell phone instead. So they were kind enough to add that in as a bonus. They also gave us this adorable magazine. It's You Dolls, and inside it actually has blank pages for your doll to write in, or you, or you know, whatever. But it's cute. And then we also got a couple of these. I guess since they knew it was a mother-daughter, they gave us these cute, they look like volleyball keychains, and they say the name of the company, You Dolls. So that is the You Doll, and we are very happy with her. We think she's adorable. She's definitely different looking from Barbie. And if you'd like, I would like to do a comparison video to a Barbie doll. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and let me know, and I will try to go ahead and do that. And so here is Katie, and I like to call her Mini Katie. And then also, I wanted to give you a preview of the website and how fun it is for you as a doll collector, or as a gift for another doll collector, or even your own little girl, to get on the website and choose the different items. So let me go ahead and add that in as some more footage at the end Okay, of so this here we video. are at the You Dolls site, and it says create your own dolls, and it looks like the price is still the same, $49.99. It says four easy steps to create your one-of-a-kind dolls. So it's really cool. You go to youdolls.com, It tells you everything you need to know about the dolls and how to create them. And you start with the, let's see, it keeps scrolling on me here. So let me try to get to the main screen. Right here, you pick the skin tone. It's asking you to join their mailing site. And it shows you the different types of dolls that you can pick. And right here, it's showing you all the different dolls, which is cute. This reminds me of how American Girl used to be, where they would allow you to pick out the doll of your choice with the skin color, eye color, and hair color. Apparently, American Girl is no longer doing that. So if you needed a doll with, say, medium skin, just for fun, I'm going to pick one that looks like me. This is going to show you all the dolls with medium skin. Then you would pick the doll with the eye color. And just like American Girls, they don't have very many choices. So the eye colors are blue, green, and brown. I would choose brown. And now here you're left with the dolls with medium skin and brown eyes. And then you choose the color. Blonde, brown, highlights, black, pink, or red. My hair is a very dark brown, almost black, so I will pick black. And then here are the two choices I could pick. Obviously, I do not have straight hair, so I would pick this girl. She has medium skin, brown eyes, and black long curly hair, so that would totally be me. So this would be the doll that would look like Mom Loves Dolls too if I were making this doll. And this is cool. You can scroll over and see it a little bit bigger. And so then you would just select this doll. And then here comes the other fun part, which is choosing the outfits. And you can mix and match a little bit according to what's already here. Like this is the outfit my daughter chose right here. So she's got the little shirt, the jeans, and the sneakers. But she could have chosen a skirt and boots instead with the same top. Or over here, she could have chosen like more of a cowgirl look. So anyway, these are the choices. If you go to their website, you'll have so much fun looking and just picking out, even if you don't buy the doll, just picking it out for fun, which is what I'm doing now. So for me, let's see, if I were gonna pick an outfit, let me see. Not as easy as it looks to pick something out, huh? All right, just for fun, I'm going to pick this one. So it's called Country at Heart. Select this fashion. So now I have my doll and I have my fashion. And then you can pick from these different collections. So here's collection one, collection two, etc. And they all come with different things. So if you're a guitar player, a tennis player, if you love dogs, etc., you can pick from these things. When they were starting out, you were actually allowed to pick the individual items themselves. Now they're in a collection, so you get the four items that are in the collection. So let me see. I would obviously pick something that's closest to me. I'm not a tennis player, so those are out. I'm not a boogie board person, that's out. I don't have dogs because I'm allergic, so that's out. I don't play volleyball, that would be out. So you just have to kind of look and see, you know, which one you like. I don't play an instrument, so I wouldn't pick one with an instrument. So that's a little bit tough because it's hard to pick. It looks like most of them come with some sort of instrument. So then you can, I guess, pick and choose for something that you do like. I would probably pick probably this one because I do like the violin and I like the little laptop. The doggy's cute and I would get this one, so I'll just grab that one just for fun. And so then after that, you pick a scene that the box will have when the box arrives. This is the one my daughter chose, the Eiffel Tower. I do like Christmas, so I'm going to pretend this is a Christmas gift and I'll just select that, which is Santa and the reindeers. And then here you go. You just confirm your doll. It shows you the doll you picked, the outfit, the accessories, and the box. And then you can also name your doll. So if I was going to actually order this, I would name her Mom Loves Dolls too. So it actually makes a great gift if you know a doll collector, and then you add it to the card, it'll give you the price and the shipping, etc. So I just wanted to show you that so that you can see that creating your own new doll is actually a lot of fun. So thank you all so much for watching. Bye!